Hi everyone, my name is Ivan. I'm from the Tech Guide channel. So in this video I'm going to show you how to upgrade your old Samsung tablet. More exactly, I'm here with a Samsung Galaxy Note version 10.1, and one of the big problems that we have with this model, it's a lot of applications are not working anymore. Let me show you, for example, YouTube. When I try to open YouTube, I'm going to receive this message about I need to update the app. And when I click and update it, and try to update it from the Play Store, I'm going to receive a new screen with only two options: uninstall or open. Let's open the app again. And we're going to receive again the same screen as the beginning. So as you can see, we are in a kind of looping here with YouTube. But also, if you try to install new apps, like for example Zoom or Meet or Classroom or Team, it doesn't allow you to install those apps because it has an old Android version. Let me show you more exactly what model I'm talking about. This is a GT-N8010 model, and its Android version is the 4.1.2. So as you can see, it's an old Android version, which is the source of our problem here. So to fix that, we need to upgrade the operating system. So this process, it could be a little tricky, but the idea of this video is try to explain step by step how to make that process. So let's start. First of all, let me turn off the tablet, because we need to put it into a don't do it mode. So for do that, we need to use a combination of keys, which are the power button and the power and the K down volume key, which is this one. So we need to press and hold those keys at the same time until we get a new screen, which is this one. So for continue, press the K up volume key, which is this one. So here we are. We are in the download mode, and this will allow us to upload files into the tablet. And let me show you what file are we going to need. We're going to use these files, but don't worry, I'm going to leave in the description of the video, I'm going to leave the link so you can download those files. So the first installation is the Samsung USB driver, because we need that our PC recognize the tablet once connected by USB. So open that file, and you are going to make double click on the setup.exe file. Just click next, install. I got this message because I already installed the driver, but I don't going to do that again. But in your case, just click and continue. So once this driver is installed, we're going to go back to the main folder. And the second app that we need is this one, the Odin tree. We are going to open that folder, and we are going to run the .exe file, but as administrator. So right click and click and run as administrator. Click on OK. So this program, it would be allows to upload file to the tablet. So let's put in here. Okay, the next step is connect the USB cable to our tablet, which is this one. Let me connect it. So, one is connected. You are going to see this message here in blue. It tells you that the tablet is connected through the COM5 port, which is great. So, the first file that we are going to load is this one, the auto root. It's for root the tablet. So for load that file, we are going to make click in the AP button. Just open and select the auto root file, which is this one. Open up. And you are going to click in the start button to start the upload. So you are going to see it's very quick, the installation. The tablet is rebooted, and when the tablet started, we are going to set the tablet as a root. Okay, here we are. So we need to repeat the first step. We need to turn off to put it again into the download mode. Okay, yeah. Then again, power button and K down key. Okay, so for continue, press K up volume key, and we are again in the download mode. So we need to load now the second file, which is TWRP, which is this one. So again, click on the IP button and select TWRP. Open the file, and before start with the upload, you are going to click on the option tab and uncheck the auto reboot option. And then click on start. So as you can see here, the upload was succeed since we got again the pass message. So for use TWRP, we need to put the tablet in the boot mode. So for do that, we're going to use again another combination of keys, which are a power button and K up volume key. We are going to press and hold both keys at the same time until the screen turn off, the tablet turn off once. Okay, once the tablet turning on again, we release the power button and keep holding the K up volume key. This is for access to the boot mode, and the application that we're going to start is the TWRP, which is this one. Here we are. This is how looks the interface. Okay, so the first thing that we're gonna do is a backup of our data, of our current data. We click on backup. And the idea is to save this file into SD card memory. You can choose by clicking storage and click in this option to select and click on OK. And to start the backup, you need to swap this button here. And then the backup process is started. You can check here the progress of the backup status. Okay. Once the backup finished, we need to go back to the main screen. Again, go back. Okay. And now we need to copy a couple of files. We need to copy the files that we are going to install in the tablet, which are Lineage, this version. This is the new operating system that we are going to install. And the second one is OpenGaps, and this is the Google App service. So we need to copy these two files. Copy, and we are going to go to our tablet device, which is this one. Open up, and we are going to copy it in the internal storage. So open up and look for the TWRP folder, which is this one. Open up and paste here this file. Okay. Once we are copied the file, let me put more bigger the screen. We go to our tablet, unblock by swap this button again, and we are going to go to install option. And the idea here is look the files that we copy in the tablet memory. So we are going to select storage. Open up. And then select the internal storage. This is the first option here. And click on OK. And we are going to search the TWRP folder. You can scroll down. This is the folder we select, clicking in the folder. And we are going to see the files that I already copied. So the first file that we are going to use is the Lineage. So we select the file and swap the button to start the flash the tablet memory. And it could take a couple of minutes. Okay, great. It's already flashed, so we are going to go back to the main screen, and now we select the Open Gaps file, and again swap the button to start with the flash. And again, it will take a couple of seconds or minutes, maybe a minute too. Okay, it finished. We are already flashed the tablet memory successfully. So we are going to go to the main screen, go back again, and then we are going to wipe the memory by select this option, and again just swap this button to wipe. Okay, now we are going to review the tablet by clicking in this button, review system. And again, we need a new option. This time is for install this app in the tablet. And swap the button, and that's all. We are going to see the tablet reviewed again, and if the installation was succeed, we are going to see the new logo of the new operating system. And here we are. It will be take a couple of minutes also before the load finish. Okay. You can disconnect now the cable from the tablet. We don't need it anymore. And here we are. We got the new operating system installed in the tablet successfully. Let me turn off the light for let's see it more clearly. And let me show you real quick how the interface looks like. Click on start. Okay, next. If you need to backup, I don't select this option. Okay, I need to link a Google account here. Okay, and read the terms. Skip. No thanks. Next. And start. Here we are. This is the interface of the Lineage. Okay, let's check. Now, for example, let's install YouTube, which is one of the applications that it wasn't working in the other version. Install. Okay, let's open the app. Here we are. We get the YouTube app working properly. And the same for any other app that you need to install. So, yep, that's pretty much it. So, thank you. And I hope this video was useful for you guys. Thank you.